Yesterday, His Excellency President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni delivered an address on the State of the Nation to Parliament. We speak to Council Michael Abonika to analyze his speech. Welcome, Council. What were the hits and misses of the President's speech?
I think number one, that he was able to deliver it. Of course, it wasn't on the time like we all expected, but he was able to deliver it. The hits for me is that he was able to speak to the security issues that everyone has been talking about, saying that they will get them as usual. And then the issue about a bit of foreign policy, Operation Sujia and the rest, talking about, you know, how many ADF they have killed. Rarely do those things come out. And I was a bit happy when, you know, he's talking a bit of the foreign policy, because usually they say these are security matters, but to give an accountability. Because you see, the State of National Address is a sort of accountability of what the President has been able to do and the government. The other one critical is the issue of how he's going strong on environment issues and asking that the local government now need to be empowered to ensure that people are out of wetlands and the like, which is also a critical thing because the earth is burning. And we need to look at critically how wetlands are being depleted or not. The other issue is about the issue about cattle rustling. He came out vividly, and for him to say there will not be any Turkana coming into Uganda with any arm, I hope that one is put to implementation. The other bit is about, you know, the fact that he, as the president, they're talking about building more schools, 116 schools, and then laboratories in terms of, as the government, and also improving infrastructure. And actually, infrastructure, if you look around, they have done some quite some well in terms of road network, the tarmacking, major roads are connecting each other. So I think that, to me, those were the major aspects. Of course, with the economic growth, he didn't talk much about it, but I just said, you know, we've tried to curb inflation, but I think it's actually higher. So in terms of economy, they are saying the household incomes have increased and we are stabilizing. I am not sure how that is playing out with everyone, but he was able to touch a bit about almost everything that was of concern to us.
Did the president make a fair assessment of Uganda's current situation?
No, I think it was still up there. The State of Nation, I think we need to actually put emphasis on State of Nation, not the address. Because the address is the act of you telling us what is the state of the nation as is. Because if you have 60% of rural Ugandans still poor, then that's a big problem. So it does not give the concrete evidence of what is happening. PDM, you can't say that PDM is doing great and we are fighting poverty. PDM has been just rolled out, and there are issues of corruption of how PDM money has been eaten. So that is not correct in terms of how we are now. Security issues, there's still a lot of gun violence, and I don't know whether there are any mechanisms that the government is proposing to put in place, because after day you hear about gun violence. So I think that, especially to the income, household income, that one is still far from what the president is saying, because people do not have the cash in their pockets, like they say, they cannot be able to make life.
The president said that Uganda's economic outlook is bright and that Uganda is producing surplus for export. Do you agree?
In terms of books, yes, numbers, and again, I don't believe so much in numbers, and yet people want to use numbers. We don't eat numbers. We need to see the implication of that. If our exports have increased, meaning we are earning more money, where is the money? Can we feel it as Ugandans? So I may not categorically say that, no, these are the figures, but beyond the figures, if coffee exports have increased in tons, then we have received revenue. Where has that revenue gone? What is it doing? So just to use coffee, but what happens to other, you know, the means of production? I know they're saying, yes, milk is increasing, but where are we selling it? At how much? And what is the value addition? So beyond just saying our exports have increased, what is the impact? why do we still have a large balance of payment and importing more when we actually exporting, when the exports have increased? Yeah.
The president spoke of the parish development model as the solution to poverty in the country. He has high hopes in this. Do you believe that the parish development model can alleviate Ugandans from poverty?
Unfortunately, the present race has high regards in the project of the time. He had high regard in Monawaga Gawale, high regard in the youth livelihood program, high regard in PDM, high regard in Mioga, but it didn't work. So, once bitten, twice shy. So I think that as the president, I think there's someone who doesn't give him the true story. You can't fight poverty with money. That cannot work. Because you see, you're giving each household 1 million shillings at a parish level. What are they going to do that for when they have school fees issues? So I do not think that the PDM is the best models to actually elevate Ugandans out of poverty, because you cannot fight poverty absolutely with money.
Thank you, Councillor Michael Abonika. That has been this week's News Digest with me, Vivian Kamsimi.